Ramon, how we looking? How we looking? Good to go. Live and direct, that's what it is. Okay, let's get locked and loaded, y'all.
Hit it.
Yes, let's hit it. What is it, April 19th? April 19th.
20th, yeah.
April 20th? So you're right.
21st, yeah.
My fault, April 21st. All that talk they was doing yesterday with that 420, I know I was supposed to know that. Yes, indeed. Everybody. Okay, April 21st, 2021. Let's get locked and loaded, y'all, for another episode. Live and direct, y'all. Let's make history. Let's take history. Let's tape history. That's what it is, y'all. April 21st, 2021. Free Amon Radio here, Intellectual Radio. Another episode. Program of Black Panther Party Cubs, hosted by yours truly, Chairman Fred Hampton Jr. and Robert Allen, a.k.a. The Lady of Rage. That's what it is, y'all. We locked and loaded, y'all. You have to call in 929-477-3785. Then press 1 to be heard or to get in. Because I'm on the studio phone right now at the 708 number, Intellectual Radio. With that being said, y'all, let's do what it do. Let's go straight into it. Intense, as we see, you can't say this enough. Intense times, situations are moving a million miles a minute, y'all. So, number of things to talk about is, I mean, as we speak, I was coming in. I'm gonna call upon the listeners and the people to bring me up to speed on a few things. Something about the police just shot some young lady or something 4 times. I'm hearing bits and pieces. I'm not familiar with that. Also, the big response, and we're going to, I think, Congresswoman Stephen Maxine Waters have made. I'm not familiar with that. Again, bits and pieces. I've been literally out the loop for a minute, but in the loop, you know what I'm saying? Out of range, how that sound? Out of range, you know what I'm saying? So feel free, matter of fact, call in, and you know what I'm saying, bring the chairman up to speed. I think our co-host may be joining us shortly. In the meantime, between time, and after that, let's keep y'all heads up, y'all eyes open, y'all fists clenched. Want to get y'all response. What you think? What's your thoughts? We put our official position from the Black Panther Party Cubs out in regards to the verdict rendered yesterday on the case of Derek Chauvin, former Minneapolis police, in regards to the murder of George Floyd. There are 3 more. Minneapolis, are they former? Have they been technically fired? Or what's the status? They have upcoming court dates. Basically, opposition is, again, keep your guards up. Because this, as I said, as I articulated, this system is a serial sucker puncher. A serial sucker puncher. In other words, throw out certain moves and, you know, say, come back with different taxes, the appeal process, you name it. You know, keep our guards up. She was 15 or 16. Called the cops before they showed up and didn't de-escalate. They just shot her 4 times. Well, this is in Chicago. I'm just literally hearing this like minutes before I walked in the studio. Let me know if this is Chicago.
That's Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah. Columbus, Ohio? Okay. Okay.
And she had apparently she was fearing she was being jumped on.
Mm-hmm.
And so she called the pig because the girls were, you know, jumping on her or getting ready to jump on her. So she had a knife, of course, defending herself against the girl.
Mm-hmm.
And then the pig just came through and saw knife and gunned her down.
Yeah.
You know, she called.
Yeah.
Yeah,
this is something, you know. The deal is, just even with that, that bit of information there, we'll go as far as to say that, can't be reiterated enough, you know, in regards to the media, schools, police, and dynamic. It all, at minimum, it always has to be assessed. Healthcare, how, you know, vaccinations, the race question is a defining factor, how we, you know, how we deal with it, how it deals with us. And the deal is, you know, so many cases, you know, we talk about, you know, even psychiatric mental issues. You know, many times, you know, our therapy has to, you know, send, go through, you know, send liquor stores, the crack houses, you know, or what have you, because we're not afforded the Dr. Fields and the couches. Even there are issues within the community. We struggle to stabilize our communities to a point that we can deal with our own contradictions, you know, and like, you know, and it's one of the fallouts of destabilizing the community is the state forces. Okay, now your forces, with Chairman Freya say, basically called Frank James, stop what Jesse James has done. And so the trickle down impact of any attack, you know, say, has, you know, saying, I mean, this is, people say, damn, you damn if you do, damn if you don't. And but again, this system, it produces a, it also has the ecosystem. It's like, you know, like you go to the, you know, you go to the poachers. Or better yet, before the poachers, you know what I'm saying, the imperialists, whether, you know, Britain, you know, America, what have you. You know, how they set, you know, setting the climate up, you know, everything from depriving the gorillas and other natural habitants, their natural food, you know what I'm saying, and they bait them, and then now, you know what I'm saying, so now they're forced to go look for the food, the bait, now the poachers, you know what I'm saying, get that, and it also the whole ecosystem. It's kind of like this discussion that came up one time in regards to this TV show, Bait Car, in which, or even it was a big thing too in Inglewood, Chicago, these bait trucks, where they had placed these trucks inside the community, and the pigs on the south side of Chicago were literally waiting there. And many people just came in, had a reaction and response, but they was breaking into this truck with these gym shoes. Negating the external circumstances and stuff that we have to deal with, something we have to, you know, to put, you know, in this context, you know, everything ranging from the type of what this system has produced of a community that's, you know, chasing after these gym shoes, exactly, right on. So I just tapped in that, right on, go figure, entrapment, and the psychic, you know, again, the addiction, you know what I'm saying, on name brand, you know, the type of shoes. The even impact our relationships, how we view, you know, each other, you know what I'm saying? Say, okay, let me see what type of shoes you wear. In fact, there's a thing I'm always dealing with our chapter in Brazil. And we were talking about the historical dealing of shoes, how there were shoes. And it was brought to our, you know, to my attention that I think our deputy chairman was talking to us about, like, on many of the plantations in Brazil, it was common for those who wanted a plantation to wear these sandals or these shoes around their necks. And it was like a status that you had these particular sandals, you know, these sandals during chattel slavery. Not that you're using the shoes to walk, but it, you know, some people look and say, oh, look at those shoes around their necks. And so every day, you know what I'm saying, and it trickles down, you know what I'm saying, it's not even, it defies logic. You know, but the deal is, it reduces those who are subjected to it, colonized, you know what I'm saying, to it. You know what I'm saying, you go along with certain procedures, you know, people to say, well, this is my definitions are, even though I'm not getting the benefit from it, but it represents that of the ruling class. And so, again, the whole ecosystem is offset. Crime and, you know what I'm saying, it contradictions in our community. We find ourselves, you know what I'm saying, in many cases, resorting to reactionary responses, you know, calling upon the same individuals, same system that's responsible. You know, like I said, just even with that, you know, like in Rwanda, you know, it was, you know, how the Chinese had did these radio broadcasts, it was between the Hutus and Tutsis, and simultaneously, right, the mysterious plane crash, the leadership of one of the maybe the Hutus, and it really was a one people, but it was class contradictions that the system had exploited. And then, you know, the timing of the butcher, the knives and stuff that was placed into the community, and the role that Belgium and the French and other imperialistic powers played with that, and, you know, in creating this genocide, not this fratricide being, you know, brothers killing brothers, or, you know, same people killing each other. Then shortly thereafter, the same system, you know, being held up, said, we need the courts, whether it be the Belgium, the French, to put, you know, to come lock up the opposing community, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like, you know, the old African axiom that says, you know, when elephants fight, the grass suffers, you know. So even in our community, at the end of the day, you know, many cases they have, you know, half of us in the graveyard, rest of us in the penitentiary, you know, the concentration camps. But feel free, call in, Cub in with us. 929-477-7385 and press 1. We're talking about that. Even, you know, say, update me, you update us with more information you have. Some of the verdict rendered in Minneapolis yesterday. You know what I'm saying? Keep that head up on this end, Chi-Town. Feel free to Cub in with us. Feel free to call in with us, you know? I missed a few days on the trial watching it because it's difficult, like, even we're talking about the gaslighting process, because out of fear of just asking certain questions, the insult to your intelligence, that there's even a trial. That there's actually a discussion going on about this. Clearly, what you're saying, I mean, imagine you're within our community, you come in, you know, eight-plus minutes, you know, someone knee on your neck, you know what I'm saying? That there's actually a discussion, you know what I'm saying? And again, the impact it has on your, you know what I'm saying, on your psyche, the constant be asked, you know what I'm saying, was this murder or not? And you clearly see what it was. So we're going to talk about that case. Talking about the flyer. Let me just also say this in regards to the verdict. Because like in so many cases, the system will bring their, as Malcolm X referred to them, as their responsible leaders in and say it was due to that. Let the record reflect. There was no mass voters registration event held prior to this verdict being rendered. There was no mass education rally prior to this verdict. The masses of people, you know what I'm saying, throughout Minneapolis, throughout, you know what I'm saying, the ghettos, you know what I'm saying, and barrios, you know what I'm saying, throughout the world, the potential response to that potential powder keg, that being the people, this is what is historically, is, you know what I'm saying, has impacted, so that, you know what I'm saying, history. There was no new laws implemented. There was no, you know, appealing to the morale of the judge or the court system. There was that, you know what I'm saying, that of the potential response of the people. That's what we're talking about, y'all. So again, y'all feel free. Any callers and cues to the comrade?
Yeah, my old brother, Chairman,
callers
and cues, callers, if you'd like to come into, please press 1.
Free them all. Y'all feel free on Instagram. Y'all feel free to call in. You know, I'm just getting back on location. I've been out on the land with the people. Man, out of communication, you know what I'm saying, out of range, you know, and you know, and wherever we go, we do what we tend to do with Chairman Fred. So he put our ear to the ground and feel the beat of the people. You know what I'm saying? Learn so much. You know, we'll talk about that too for the conclusion of the show. We'll talk about that, y'all. Some of the upcoming discussion was going on with the Oscars. They're saying, well, this, how is it a discussion about two of the major actors, Daniel Kaluuya, portrayed Chairman Fred, and Keith Stanfield, portrayed William O'Neill. It doesn't fit the conventional definitions, and the opposition was and is. None of the dynamics to get to the stage in the game about this movie has fit the definition of conventional definitions. Why aren't we moving to Africa? When we say we, Devontae, give me a little more clarity. Is that no trick question? I want to open the door for some other discussion too, guys. I was actually going to talk about the dynamics of race, in particular also Minneapolis, and the vagueness, how, you know, even how race is assessed. Black people. We are, I can answer in absolutes. I will say this, that, you know, I think it's important that, you know, we put Africa, we put black people in the correct context also. A lot of people say, well, what do you mean? I mean, in this abstract, one of Chairman Fred's speeches, he talked about, he said, you think all they're wearing in Africa is dashikis? And he said, cats over there wearing, you know, they're wearing 357s and bandoliers across their chests also. And there's one brother named, I spoke out there on the panel in Florida, he said something to the effect, he said, He said, you think it's just kings and queens in Africa? He said, you don't think there's no hustlers and you don't know dice shooters and all the different dynamics that exist in the real world. And there are contradictions. I'm talking about the imperialists. I mean, whether you know what I'm saying? I mean, there's a discussion that's going on. I mean, with the reactionary force out of China, let alone with the white people, you know what I'm saying? The role that they're throughout the homeland is intense. And so I think we should be up front and have this romanticism that, you know, the homeland is not being impacted by imperialism. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, so we've seen, what was the case? What was the guy's name? The big case. They had, it was an occupied Isaiah. They showed, and I was like, wow. You seen the background of it. You know, so it was that case, that white athlete had a case, a murder case on his own. Maybe his ex-wife, and he was a famous athlete, and you can see the dynamics, you know, how imperialism has impacted the homeland. So I think we should put that in context also. There, this system is, you know, hitting us everywhere, you know, everywhere, you know, and also not to even mention the contradiction about resources. Cause like even there was a question raised in New Orleans after Hurricane America. A lot of people referred to the Hurricane Katrina. A lot of people said, why they just didn't leave? And they'll, you know, say, you know, stuff that many people take for granted, that people have actual resources that they're not living or existing day to day. You know what I'm saying? That, you know what I'm saying? That we don't have the ability, a lot of us, to be, you know, to be transient, to move around. We want to move around. So I can't limit it to one answer. There's so many different dynamics in regard to that. Before we put the question out, that we should, it's a humbleness to say, wait a minute, I can't draw a foregone conclusion that everyone is able to, you know, leave the south side of Chicago to get to the west side of Chicago. You know, it's like when the trains, the timing under the Mayor Rahm Emanuel administration with the red line, the trains they're directly in the hood, the urban community, that these trains were shut down. And a lot of people say, well, what's the big deal? And where children have to go through different areas or different cliques, you know what I'm saying, to be able to get home, and how this impacted, you know what I'm saying, the crime rate, and so many other different dynamics. So I think we should really put this in correct context, you know what I'm saying? And I just draw for a full conclusion that everyone wants to get back home. And I recommend another book called Black Yankees. It talks about a lot of those who were liberated, or, you know what I'm saying, got freed themselves from the plantations down in the South. During the era of chattel slavery, there was a populace of those who, quote-unquote, escaped from up South to go back South, and, you know what I'm saying, shit, please master. Y'all forgive me this coffee waking up, because I'm on different time zones. We need to reprogram my dialogue when we think of Africa right now, because that's the program of slavery versus reality, not Africa and us in America. I think the class contradiction also transcends, should be also inclusive in the conversation. There are those who, you know, in the homeland, who connect with a certain status of people here, you know what I'm saying, throughout the diaspora. Have you seen or heard about the listing of Illinois PPP recipients? No. Enlighten us. I'll forgive and run through this coffee like I don't know what. If you can, feel free to call in. Call in if you can. Have you seen or heard about the listing of Illinois PPP recipients? No. Yeah, I'm just very hurt. And with the PTSD from the release because of Black Trip. Rightfully so. The people's pain reflects. We all should be hurt. That was happening, I've been no doubt about it. Talking to me in light of this, I don't think so. I'm not really clear. Are you talking to me in light of this? I'm not clear of your question. I'm not clear of the question. But the PVP, feel free to call in the Cub being with us on that. I see my brother Archie Davis in the building. Man, love and respect at you, my brother. Real talk. I've been out of range. Y'all know they didn't tip me off Facebook. We're working on getting that page back set back up. We're working on that. If we come down to it, we're going to use 2 10 cans in the stream. Sorry, I didn't mean I don't think so. I house. Okay, understood. No problem. No problem. Understood. Yeah, you know, this technology is something else. Feel free. Feel free to call in the club being with us, y'all. Your thoughts on the verdict rendered yesterday, April 20th. You know, I'll give a shout out to our brother Robert Money's birthday was yesterday. We went out there and showed our respect. I know a lot of y'all were celebrating some other stuff April 20th. You know, just the FYI, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, some other birthdays too that yesterday. But your thoughts on, so you know what I'm saying? Again, what, you know, because the sentencing date is set to be coming up. We want to definitely say keep your guards up. Also, in regards to the other police who said they're going to trial. And I think it was recently reported that Derek Chauvin was supposedly set on suicide watch in the maximum security prison. You know what I'm saying? So, you have to be real cautious with these type of different dynamics. You know what I'm saying? This can be setting the stage. Where, you know, we have to release him to the farm. Because we talk about, again, as I said, in the opening of the show, talk about even the regards to the police, you know what I'm saying? It was an episode on Good Times where, you know, they need the police. You know, like, you don't call the police. And they called the police. And they was like, man, the police ain't even going to come. And then I think JJ's character, someone said, well, tell me, there's a white lady downstairs. A person just snatched. And the police pulled up with the quickness. So everything, it's got like an episode also, Living Color, where he was showing the news. And the news was showing a black family and a white family watching the news. And with the different narratives that came in, depended upon which respective race of people we're talking about. And this is something we have to acknowledge. And, you know, we are realists, not racists. We are realists, we're not racists. But it has to be inclusive in the conversation, in particular in America. In particular in America. Yes, indeed.
Free them all, Brother Chairman.
Free them all, Mr. Conrad.
We have Brother Upfire. Do you mind? Free them all.
Free them all. Welcome to Free them all Radio.
I had made a comment about inquired that seen or heard about the listing of the PPP recipients here in Illinois.
Hmm.
So, and like, I felt like, you know, the whole situation is, you know, just a whole other government setup, man. A whole other, you know, setup, man. A situation that's gonna spiral into our community in the worst way. Because, I mean, what they're doing is listing not only these major businesses, but you know, anybody who's applied for a PPP loan and actually got one, you can even search it by zip code, man. And I'm talking about it's giving the people's name, the expected amount, when the amount was dispersed.
Hmm.
And what do you think something like that is going to do in our communities? You know what I'm saying?
Real talk. Okay, just for those who may not be in the know, you can't just give us a little background. We won't draw no foregone conclusions what the PPP loans are. You know what I'm saying? Then bring us to speed if you can. You know, we don't, you know, it's been a common conversation about, you know, in regards to the loans, the grants, about, you know, applying for it. But if you can, the government, you know, basically government assistance. And, brother, you're saying that, you know what I'm saying, in particular with the COVID, with businesses, and in so many cases, what we're talking about, the welfare recipients, what we're talking about, you know, crime, the image of the people get the brunt of the propaganda, like this, you know, it's us, you know, the masses. But then you start getting the details, the background players, the businesses that, you know what I'm saying, different policies that come out, you know, the amount of crime they involve, the amount of resources they get in the tax write-offs. But if I'm correct, you're saying that in response to these, applying for these loans, that there's a general listing being put up of people's information when they apply, when they said to get their resources and to get the money. And you're saying, you know, can we imagine the fallout from that? You know, we see just even how the income tax return game impacts our community. You know, so, I mean, we have, you know, countless of cases, you know, where, you know, people got into it with each other all of a sudden, tax time, and how it impacts, you know, our relationships to who lives here, so on and so forth. So, and also, in addition to that, the question of information. You know, people, you know, saying, because the Black Panther Party position was that, which we relate to, information is raw material for new ideas. Again, that's good and bad. Information is raw material for new ideas. There's certain things that you, if you know, you don't know, it limits your ability to move forward, you know, since, you know, by even thinking about, you know, sticking up someone or taking something from, or, you know, once applied a certain, provided a certain amount of information, it opens it just, again, for new ideas, and that's not all, that's not always a good thing. So, yeah, I wasn't familiar with that, this, you know what I'm saying, and, you know, this is,
And on top of that, brother, it was like, I mean, like I said, it listed not only, like I said, major businesses. I mean, like, you just, like, the major news, like you can literally see what the mayor got.
Wow.
And as far as it is for PPP, all the way down to, you know, Joe Schmo off whatever.
Wow.
You know, in whatever zip code in the city, man. And it's just like, I feel like that's going to create more issues for people than what's already going on. And then to make it even worse, it's like when you have legitimate businesses who did apply for work and were denied, and then you see some of these major corporations on this list getting grant $2 million like that, it's also upsetting, you know what I'm saying, as a black business owner or as a black business who's trying to start a business or something who couldn't get assistance, but you see companies who are already well established getting more assistance probably than what they really needed.
Man.
You know, so I mean, it's like either way the list is informative in several aspects, but definitely the first thing that came to my mind when I saw it was just like you're putting targets on people.
Real talk. Okay. Real talk. That's I agree 100%. This, everything that this, you know, I mean, this system, I mean, whatever, you know, I mean, I'll be so, well, you know, you're paranoid, but I tell you, like, even, you know, I come from a generation where, you know, there was the black and white box where they had the free cheese and free peanut butter, quote unquote, free cheese and free peanut butter, ain't nothing free with it, particularly capitalism, you know, and it was talked about later on about, you know what I'm saying, about the time and they did these tests and they talking about, like, even, with peanut butter and with the particular cheese, and you know what I'm saying, how the long range health ramifications that it had on the people. And this system thinks long range, and so it works with the carrot and the big stick. In other words, you know, certain concessions that come through to ease you down, and you know what I'm saying, again, it thinks long range, and just not even going to a big long political layout. You know, people know, I think of the case with Pop Smoke, the young cat that was robbed and gunned down in L.A. at the Airbnb of one of the ladies, famous lady, housewives or the rich and famous, I think L.A. or something, or Beverly Hills or something. But they were talking about, you know, how he was targeted after the images of him, you know, with the bankroll, with the money, and, you know, said, you know, we, yeah, and then, this is age, day and age of tech, you know, intense, I mean, high tech technology, where, you know, cats can trace you down, so on and so forth, and, you know, just even I'm not even thinking with the mind of a lunatic or the mind of an imperialist, better yet, but just, I mean, relationships, you know, man, you call it, hey, I ain't seen you. Your daddy got this in, and you know what I'm saying? He's staying over there, such and such, or vice versa, whatever the case may be. So, yeah, this system now, I'm talking about, man, it doesn't miss a beat. It does not miss a beat. It does not miss a beat, you know? And this is something that, you know, consciously, we've been so subjected to so many cases. Like, even that newspaper that they get out with people's names and faces are plastered over the paper. They was charged with this case, you know? And just, it opens the door, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, you go into the job, the job tell you, oh, man, you got this and that, you know what I'm saying? It's mind-blowing.
And to what you just said, I wanted to ask you then, so why is it, as far as this society, that any of our accomplishments, whatever it may be, or how we choose to express, like you just made mention, okay, Pop Smoke, for example, okay? Mm-hmm. We flashed his money, jewelry, et cetera. Now, why does that, you know, and they ask, I mean, why is that used to justify being murdered or justify whatever happened? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, he got murdered. It wasn't because he flashed his money or no nothing like that. I mean, mm-hmm. it was because more or less he was a celebrity who had money.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's like they use whatever.
Whatever. Damn if you do. Damn if you don't.
Yeah,
damn if you do. You know, it's 6-1 hand, half a dozen other. You know, at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? Again, it's this is a system that was built, that was birthed. You know what I'm saying? Of the exploitation of, you know what I'm saying, the slave trade. This wasn't a side hustle. You know, it wasn't like, you know, the Portuguese, the Spaniards, you know what I'm saying, the British. They were major car thieves, and they said, you know what, let's just bring in slave trade also to help our hustle out. They was, you know, big time shipbuilders. Come on, a system that was, you know what I'm saying, that was you know, subjected to, you know what I'm saying, to the potato famine, and, you know what I'm saying, all type of different dynamics, you know what I'm saying? And this was, I mean, you had warring tribes, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't even a uniform concept of Europe. You had the Vandals and barbarians, you know what I'm saying? So this whole, the whole inception of it, you know what I'm saying, the slave trade, like, you know, I'm sure many of the, you know, myself and my counterparts, as well as others, have been taught, you know, like, you know, the triangular trade, where the way it's mentioned, trade of gold, copper, oil, and what the deal is, the enslaving the African people. In fact, speaking of which, I wish I could have this brother, have his son call in. We had this brother, man, his son, very intelligent cat, youngster. I got to have him call in. This cat can't be no more than 12, 13 years old, but he was articulating and breaking down this thing. I forgot this term they use in regards to capitalism now. And, you know, and the youngster was, like, selling it. You know, he was, you know, saying, it's a new term they use now for youngsters. He was breaking it down. And I was hearing the youngster out, and I was like, man, but you know, this is the new form of the definition of capitalism. I said, well, you just can't go back and erase the historical nature where it comes from, you know, it was birth of the enslaving of African people. You know, you may tweak it, you know what I'm saying, change the name or come up, you know. In fact, I think Frederick Douglass had talked about, like, might be actually in the Constitution itself, where they say this regards to chattel slavery. This peculiar institution, that's the term they use, will attempt to rear its head again, you know what I'm saying? So these are different euphemisms that are utilized at different stages in the game. So that's, but again, at the end of the day, this is a system that again, that was birth of the kidnapping, rape, and theft of black people. And, like, even there was some struggles even with the differences that with the Marxists, Leninists, theoreticians, you know what I'm saying, well, a lot of people that, you know, fall out the line of the white left, they use the term the primitive accumulation. And primitive accumulation kind of, like, similar to, like, kind of some aspects of evolution. Like, this is the way it happens. This is the natural process of things. Like, you know, like, the you being here, well, it's negating the, you know what I'm saying, what capitalism does, you know what I'm saying, has done to our people. And this is a discussion we have with people. Some people say, well, there was slavery in Africa. We say, no, you must distinguish that, you know what I'm saying, the difference between the people that are reconcilable, difference between people instead of irreconcilable, but the gutting nature of capitalism, you know what I'm saying, it takes the humanity out of an individual. And so, with that being said, as Field Marshal George Jackson said, it not only affects the economy, but it affects the psychic of the people. So the way that we're viewed, you know what I'm saying? I was just on a radio show a minute ago, and they told me, like, just even the lady was telling me, she told me how she said her son-in-law is a police in Minneapolis. And she said, she watched him the last few days, throwing a shield, you know, getting sued and booted for what's to happen. And she said, I think her grandson is biracial. And then she said, my son is, her nephew is black. But she's breaking down the different dynamics, the reality, how they are viewed. And it's a politic to it, you know. So, I mean, I think even with the George, the footage is a, possesses the potential for political education through and through, you know what I'm saying? Just even, I had a former family, family member. When I pulled up on her to go check on, make sure she's all right for a situation she was dealing with, when her guy pulled up and the way she ran, I said, whoa. Then the guy pulled up. I said, whoa, wait a minute. I said, man, what type of situation be going on for her to move like that? What have I been missing? Even the footage of the police, the way that just the demeanor, and not only George Floyd and the others, the community in general, no way is it reflective of someone who is coming to get cats out of trees. No way is it reflective of an entity that's coming at you that you could feel comfortable that's coming to save you. It's a history of it that, you know, that right there, stop the tape. What's going on that these type of, you know what I'm saying, grown men and women, you know what I'm saying, and again, this is no slight on the community, but the heightened consciousness, say, where did this come from? How are these vehicles designed? And a lot of people just take it for granted, like, you know, well, it's just a wagon, a police car. No, it's this system. I recall I was talking with some cats one time. They would say, you know, this is all a myth, you know, about, you know, slavery, you know, it never existed. I said, yeah. He said, no, we was over here all the time. It's never. I said, dig. We deal with dialectical materialism. The way that these handcuffs are made, the way their history, they ain't no virgins with this here. This ain't their first rodeo. This system been getting down. This been going on for quite some time. So you have to say, wait a minute, even the police cars, some of them, the hard plastic in the back. I remember being placed in the back of a wagon. And, you know, and it was a new, up-to-date wagon, and, you know what I'm saying, how dark it was, you know, the different type of dark. And one of the setbacks that we have and we will incur with struggle is that we cannot even fathom the dynamics that this system deals with. In Pontiac Prison, Pontiac has a hell of a history also. Pontiac was used to be known as the Thunderdome, you know, the gladiator schools where your knuckles was tested. But Pontiac had, I think it was 1977, Pontiac 17 case where, you know, Larry Hoover, amongst others, you know, were tried for the cases. This is going down around the Attica uprisings, you know, San Quentin, Soledad, so on and so forth. But there was a meeting in which wardens from all over the country had convened at Pontiac, and they came out with some decisions to make all of the cells, the prison cells in Pontiac, shorter than the average man. And later they came with this policy that you were going to have to go on visitation with black net mask over your face and rubber grill over the mouthpiece. These are slow kill methods that impact for generations to come. They think about the psychic of your children who their first contact or their first sight of their fathers would be this individual who cannot stand up, because again, the cells are redesigned. So after a while, the body adapts. You know, so you inside a cell, you're not standing straight up. You know, so you adapt. So you're going to run around hunchback. You know what I'm saying? Then you can give a black net mask with a rubber grill on the mouthpiece. So these are different. This has to be, you know, what's in there? What's in that back of that? Why wouldn't George Floyd, you know what I'm saying, comply? That's the question. What is to this? You know, so you look at what is happening. You know, of course, you may say, okay, well, this may be a situation, a one-time thing that happened, you know what I'm saying? For all practical purposes, you know what I'm saying? If they did a stress test on, you know, black people just, when the police lights come around them, you know what I'm saying? Just that feeling, you know what I'm saying, of terrorism, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You're like, man, should I order me a dinner, get 11 more people and call the Last Supper, you know what I'm saying? Because, man, it's like potentially be a wrap, you know? So then, you know, what's inside the jails? What's going on? You know what I'm saying? Before we even get to the murder of George Floyd, I'm talking about the breaking process. What has been done to us, you know what I'm saying, to our people, and what is, you know what I'm saying, what's happening behind those walls? Why did, when United Nations, an arbitrator for United Nations said they opened to have these arbitrary prison inspections throughout the world, And even Iraq, who's at the, under the tenure of Saddam Hussein at the time, he was like, okay, we'll go with it. The U.S. in particular, they said, no, okay, call drop. Hit back if you can. Go figure. Anyone call us in queue in the meantime between time?
Brother
Chairman.
We have Combat
Mental
on the line. Free them all.
Right on. Free them all. Welcome to Free them all Radio.
Free them all.
Free them all. Right on. Free them all. Power to people. Welcome.
Power to the Chairman. You know, I was sitting up talking with my girl just talking about some things. It was something about a cause. And I thought about something you said about either capitalism debt to debt or white power was stacked it or something like that. I want you to speak to that and also to the situation where, you know, a lot of people on the news, one of the baby sisters got done, she got shot 7 times over there off, I believe, Central Park and Roosevelt the other day. And somebody get on the news, they get one of these Uncle Toms, one of these handkerchief heads, talking about some we protest when, you know, when the kids get out on the people with the terrorism. Why not speak up on that? I'm like, man, you know, Chairman talk about all this here. We're not there getting down anyway, you know what I'm saying? They probably pay up $5 right there on the spot to say it. So that's my comment, Chairman. Revolutionary level, Clinton salute to the movie, for the movie, to the people, just to the show, because a lot of things you spoke on way back 10 years ago has come to pass. Free my revolutionary love, Chairman. My little mama called a part of people and comments.
Right on. Free them all. Right on for the call. Your first question, the first point, I remember the last point. Give me a minute. Okay, so I'm gonna do the latter. Then okay, that's been a position. Maybe you say, okay, what about we have an issue even with the term black on black crime, but the deal is everything is rooted. You know what I'm saying? Again, the way we deal with each other, the way we don't deal with each other. With, you know what I'm saying? Nothing comes into the community, our community in particular, whether it be crack cocaine or chitlins or cotton, that is not, you know, the capitalism ain't got its, you know, get its pig hoofs on. You know what I'm saying? Oh, this goes back into the comment, the quote that we have. You know, people say, well, you why would you like to bring the race? You can't play the race card for everything. And our position is that white power dealt the deck, and capitalism controls the cards. The question, you know, some racism, as Chairman Fred says, is a tool used by capitalism. However, let me say this too now when we're talking about it. This is a lot of times why in Minneapolis, the question of race is kind of vague. You know what I'm saying? This is what, and many people have a reactionary assessment of race. You know what I'm saying? It's like the case of Rachel Dozell, which is clearly a white woman. And she said, well, I'm going to take the arrogant position. I'm black. In a certain location, you can run that. You can say, well, my man, this is what I am. But the deal is, a lot of people say, well, what do you mean talking black? You know, yes, that's a reality to that. Yes. Because the deal is, however you feel as an individual, at the end of the day, what populace of people, you know what I'm saying, constitute the majority of the prison population? You know what I'm saying? Who's it? You know what I'm saying? And there's not no vagueness when it comes down to that. In fact, Paul Mooney, I made a joke one time, comedian Paul Mooney had said something about, this was when Tiger Woods, the golfer, had said something like, you know, he's not black, and, you know, the term called Blasian, which, you know, saying, acknowledging the different dynamics of, you know, saying, his lineage. And Paul Mooney said, let him catch a robbery, an armed robbery tomorrow. You'll see, which, you know what I'm saying, how the news, the media, you know what I'm saying, how the police, how they view you. This is the day, you know, people say, well, and, you know, in my mind, I'm free, or I'm black, or white. That sounds good. And some people can afford that luxury to be inside that subjective bubble. You know what I'm saying? And like, certainly, you know, the deal is, like, some places, the race question is vague. And it's a lot of locations, people say, I don't like to talk about that. I don't acknowledge that. But if you don't, this is something that's taken into account at the police station. This one is taken into account the phone companies. I remember a young lady worked for, I believe, Sprint years back. And she said, even in her training, they were saying how they take phone calls, the dialect of your zip code, your last name. You know what I'm saying? And even people name their children in regards to, you know, I don't want this to your credit, because, you know what I'm saying, it's a black name. You know what I'm saying? We make jokes about it. Oh, yeah, Tyrone. So, no, that's a reality. That's a reality. You know, people pick up on who is that. You know, people say, you're talking white. You know, see, there's a certain dynamic about articulation. And people say, well, it's not. It's correct English. No, language is political. In fact, we just discussed one of the comrades, Savages, Connells. We talking about that even Connells who met Manuel at Tiny House Warriors. We talking about that was an actual tactic that the colonialists would use, not only on the indigenous and the native community, but also the black community, where the bottom of the tongue, they would cut it. They would the colonialists, the white people would cut the tongue, and this impacted how you spoke. So language, you pick up on. So you say, I've been on. You know, saying people say, man, you hear some, you say, oh, I understand what this person is, and these are telltale signs that that people use inside the community. And this is something that we're told not to acknowledge. You know, are you being raped? No, this is a reality that the ruling class acknowledges, but they tell our people don't acknowledge it. And in many cases, where it's vague, you know what I'm saying? Because people are, again, a lot of places have a reactionary response to it or assessment of it, but a lot of places it's reinforced. If you think about it, well, I don't really see it. You're reminded by the police department, and if, you know what I'm saying, when they pull you over, don't pull you over. You're reminded by the type of music or the propaganda bombs that are dropped on the radio stations. I mean, go listen to WLS. Listen to white radio stations. Try to find the misogyny, the disrespect, the stuff. Just turn it on. Try it for a minute. Go to the stores in the white community. You know what I'm saying? And you'll say, put in contrast the ingredients, you know what I'm saying, even go to the black community and try to read some ingredients and look at how offensive the merchants get it, look at you for even daring to even read it. Go to one of these fried fish stores in Chicago, fried chicken and fish stores, and ask them, do they grill, you know what I'm saying, or do they grill fish? Go check on Harold's Chicken. You know what I'm saying? A major Chicago staple. When they set up their office downtown in Chicago, when they had to list their ingredients and how much, you know what I'm saying, the type of diet that changed, type of food they started to serve there. This is a reality. This is a reality. And you know what I'm saying? And this impacts every dynamic. You know what I'm saying? There was a meme going around where they just switched the figures. They switched the faces with George Floyd and Derek Chauvin. It didn't even look right. You know, people's mind couldn't even conceive it. It didn't even conceive it. Because the outside circumstances would have not, it would have been offset. You know what I'm saying? It would have been, because you know what I'm saying? Because the reality is, opposition is also, and quote me on this. Matter of fact, retweet it and put it on Facebook. They got me banned on Facebook now, but put it on Facebook. The verdict rendered on Derek Chauvin is an aberration, but Derek Chauvin is not an aberration. This is the, you know what I'm saying? This is the modus operandi, the MO, how they operate within the black community. In fact, Minister UEP Newman drew the correlation to that of the, you know what I'm saying, the police being operating as occupying army within our community, to similar to that of the, you know what I'm saying, the U.S. soldiers in Vietnam, Philippines, Africa, and throughout the world. So this is something that we must objectively view and take into account. When we talking about credit, our brother just called in talking about this whole thing about the disclosure of those who applied and received the PPP loans, you know what I'm saying, and you best believe that some of the major players, the major gangsters and banksters, you know what I'm saying, who get the real resources, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? The question again of race, it becomes so natural, you don't even see the contradictions in it. I was just watching, I mean, look at the, what was it, Prince Williams in England, the funeral. It's a given, I'm talking about, I mean, it's literally, you see all white people, you know what I'm saying? And this is something that, you say, well, damn, it must not be no black people involved, black people there. And this is a result of policies and media. You know, so we've seen even the uproar from the royal family in England. Their discussion about, you know, seeing this other lady, the potential of a little bit of black, you know what I'm saying, you know, coming to the royal family. So these are different dynamics that, again, we have to objectively acknowledge, you know what I'm saying, and come up out of this dream world many people try to say, you know, so they end where it does not exist. We live in the Rick, y'all, at Free My Radio. Y'all feel free to call in with us. But yeah, feel free to call in with us at 929-477-3785 and press 1. Any callers in queue?
Grandma, Brother Chairman,
no
callers in queue, callers if you'd like to come into queue, please press 1.
Grandma's comrade. Right on, Over Green. Just because you don't look at race doesn't mean it's not looked at in the world. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. Let's keep our ear to the ground on all these other cases, y'all. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? And to be very clear, you know what I'm saying? Because this system is so cold with its gaslighting and Machiavellian tactics. They bring in certain individuals, state-sanctioned spokespersons, or Malcolm called responsible leaders, and say thank you for, you know, this is what this verdict was rendered because of them. It's the masses of people on the ground. You know, change comes from the bottom up as opposed to being trickled down from the top down. Change comes from the bottom up as opposed to trickling down from the top down. And that's the reality. That's the reality. That's the reality. That's what we've been saying. That's what we're going to keep on saying. That's what we're going to keep on acknowledging. Real talk. Y'all feel free to call in the Cub in. You want your comments, what your thoughts in. You know, see the upcoming Oscars. You know, see what your thoughts and comments. The verdict renderness. You know what I'm saying? I almost said Simi Valley. Simi Valley is with the LAPD. I went to court in regards to the Rodney King case. You know what I'm saying? The case, we talking about the Derek Chauvin case. Excuse me. Rendered yesterday. We're talking about, you know what I'm saying, ongoing cases of, you know, Richard J. Richard, you know what I'm saying, ongoing cases, you know what I'm saying, now Dante Wright, you know what I'm saying, Ronnie Man Johnson, your cousin, sister down the street, you know what I'm saying, also Clinch Fist Salute released the recent release of Jerry Odinga Dunnigan, yeah, yes indeed. Those who have not seen, check out that episode on 85 South, what we did with the cast down in Atlanta, you know what I'm saying, we can talk to him in. And that's good. Cousin, how you feel, family? Right on. Y'all feel free. Your thoughts, what you got going on? Feel free to call in the Cub in. Also, we will be doing a Cub and Community Caravan this Father's Day down to Chairman Fred's tombstone. That's right. We're going to check on the Chairman because Chairman came and checked up on us, y'all. It's going down this Father's Day. So y'all make sure y'all check in with us. We talking about a bus ride down. We rolling deep. We rolling deep, y'all. We live, y'all. I am not on, so I need y'all to put it out there. I'm going to get an official statement out there, too, that I am not on Facebook. I've been continuously misquoted as being on Facebook. I am not there. Shut my pages down. Chairman Fred Hampton, the real Chairman Fred Jr. and the Fred Hampton page have been shut down. How many cops have to be found guilty for these cops let up of our people? I think it's the modus operandi. Again, as we say, this is operation. Just even to be guilty. He was Derek Chauvin. Like, you know, hold on, man. Maybe it's a mistake. I think I put him on the other side, throwing it with his handcuffs on him, you know, so on their wrist. This system is rooted in it to the point that, you know, it's like, minimal, you know, if we look at the world, like, you know, the sun is in daytime, moon is in night, dogs chase cats chase mice, and white folks in control. And so, like I said, there's rumor he's supposed to be on suicide watch after the verdict was rendered. So, but the deal is there has to be, you know, continuation, because you better believe this system is, you know, it's plotting and planning. You know what I'm saying? And the repercussions are coming down. We don't even know about. You better believe they ain't locked up so many people, black people in particular, since this verdict came. So this is where we at, you know. So we live and direct, making history, taking history. That's what it is. So this is how they get out. This is how the system operates. So we have to be able to, as France Fanon, Algerian theoretician France Fanon said, to be able to accept their concessions without compromising our principles, and as well as making sure we get credit. It comes from what? The people. Yeah. I mean, cops have to be, y'all give me, yeah. Y'all feel free to call in, come in with us. I've been out on the land for a minute. The mosquitoes, told me up. So it's Conrad, we live and direct, yes indeed.
Free them all,
welcome to Free them all Radio. Right on.
Hey, what's going on? I just wanted to touch bases on, you know what I'm saying, that big case yesterday about how, you know what I'm saying, just the hypocrisy of this legal system, how we as the black racists have to sit through the bullshit and the malarkey of this legal system.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody in the world know that that kid killed that man on front of camera, and they trying to get you and the world not to believe with your eyes, dude. And then I can't help but think that the murder of my Tia Bryant made her family be prayed for and get strength to go through what they're going through, because, you know, we can't imagine what they're dealing with right now.
Say the last name again, my brother. One more time. You talking about the case?
In the way we're killing unknown black.
Give us the details of the case you're speaking on, brother. Cause
now, brother.
Give us the case you're talking about.
In Columbus, Ohio.
You're right. Give us her name again, brother. Her name again, please.
Makia Bryant.
For those who, if not for me, this is the case we were talking about earlier. I was just getting brought up to speed, literally when I was coming into the station. This is in Columbus, Ohio. Was it four times she was shot?
Yeah.
Four times
she was shot, brother.
Yes,
four
indeed.
Times she was shot. And you can see evidence how quick this kid got out that car, quick he pulled out his gun intentionally to try to kill this girl. There ain't no ifs, ands, or buts around this. You know, I'm just getting tired of these pigs. It's feeling like they got the law in their hand and it can kill any black person they see. And like I said, you know, it's a new breed of revolutionaries coming up out here, man. That's not going to back down from them pigs, yo. Because we're getting tired of it, bro. I'm getting tired. Like, I'm a black man myself. I feel threatened every time I see a pig cry by. And I ain't even doing that. You know what I'm saying? Because that might be my last day, bro. They can just see me and think that I'm aggressive. Think that I'm threatening. Just because I might have tattoos or I might be big and I'm black.
Yeah.
They want to try to harass me and be aggressive with me. And it's getting tired of it. Like I said, this new breed of revolutionaries, man. We're not going to back down from the pigs, yo. It's sickening.
I just want to add this too, that, you know, just for the narrative, let us be clear. This system don't report the resistance or those who are standing up now, let alone those in the past. So we want to definitely give honor. I mean, because a lot of times people say, well, man, people have been going for this a while. Motherfuckers been fighting back. You know what I'm saying? And it's so, I mean, and we need to, you know, even though we know it's so many cases of resistance. It's not, you know, this narrative they give us about the content slave, and you know what I'm saying, we know that we gonna one day we gonna start fighting back. No, motherfuckers been getting, you know what I'm saying, we not satisfied, you know what I'm saying. It's not to the point of you know, I just want to put that in the narrative to make sure we state that, you know.
Yeah, I feel you, brother Champion, Happy Julia, you know what I'm saying, because. You know, just like we said, you know what I'm saying? Like, everything we doing, you know, we can't get a break, yo.
Man.
Another black life in this country from the pigs every other day.
It hurts.
Every other week.
It hurts.
And we still got pigs out here.
It hurts.
That's not even had a court case. Never went to jail.
Yeah.
Ain't did nothing but the pure black lives still at home with their wives, chilling, fishing, and having a good old time. Johnny Appleseed, man.
You know, you just brought back something, too. At minimum, I mean, okay, these you know, Chauvin and rest of these serial murders, at minimum, with him walking, being handcuffed, every case that he has been, that him, let alone the Minneapolis Police Department, because, and his, I will say this, though, one thing he said, you know, they fought against, he said that his defense, his lawyer, his attorney was stating that this is how he has been trained. He's on point with that. You know what I'm saying? Their position was to dismiss him as this aberration, you know, they say a few bad apples. But this is how they've been trained. And but every case that he has been involved in, I mean, how many years they say he's been on the job? I mean, every case, they should have been, at minimum, being brought back up in the courtroom while he being cuffed walking out. You know, let's know a review. Retroactive, everything down from the traffic tickets he wrote, it's supposed to be immediately called back to, man, hold on. You know what I'm saying? How comfortable you move with this? And I think it was two or three cases that was brought up. Those who called in on this, I can't click over y'all on the radio station. I can't, hold on. Oh, damn. Free them all. Hello?
Yes, I was trying to have a question for the Elevated Vibe show.
Oh no, I'm on a different show you calling me right now. I'm on Free MR Radio. Yeah. Is this 223-8953? Yeah, but I'm doing a different show right now. Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's just the number that they have behind them, so, and that's the number they were saying to call.
All right. Hello? Hello? Fremont?
Hold on, you is dropped.
Okay.
Welcome to Blog Talk Radio. Please, you are now in the host.
Unmuted.
Fremont, right on. Back with y'all. Black with y'all. Yeah, drop. I was commenting about this case of Derek Chauvin at minimum. I mean, you come through. I mean, you and you know what I'm saying. The every case that he is individual, as well as this organized crime unit. I'm talking about, really across the board. You know, I mean, because let the tables be turned. Let's go hypothetically speaking. Let's go to hypothetical organization, you know what I'm saying? The Crowns, you know what I'm saying? Which is the fictitional organization that was, you know what I'm saying, that was put forth. Let me just say another group anyway, you know what I'm saying? Any group, you know what I'm saying, in the black community, you know what I'm saying? The coffee crew, right? Let's go with that. I mean, this individual does something, you know, you say, wait a minute. The coffee crew, that's little coffee, he done that, but how you indicting? How you going way back to the, you know what I'm saying, the coffee beans and you know, everyone, the whole, you know what I'm saying, the whole crew, you know what I'm saying? And this whole, I mean, throw the chief of police, the lieutenant, everyone, you know what I'm saying, I don't know where this come from, Derek Chauvin, get this, you know, this idea, you know what I'm saying, to be just, you know what I'm saying, this, feel this comfortable, you know what I'm saying, with his knee on the neck in broad daylight of the, of a black man, a grown individual in public, and, you know, shout out to the sister, I can't recall the sister's name, with the videotape, who videotaped it, but the reinforcement, everything, the climate from this, you know what I'm saying, what I'm saying, this is not stick out, you know, I mean, that's, imagine Derek Chauvin, you coming through, and you see Derek Chauvin with his knee on a poodle, let's go to white poodle, a poodle, you know, with a, his knee on the neck of a dog, and how that would have stuck out. I mean, other police alone, man. What is wrong with you, man? You know. In fact, I was just on these white radio stations today, and they were in the same breath talking about the verdict. We're talking about this whole thing about the puppy mill case, a new legislation that came past yesterday about how dogs are to be breeded. You know what I'm saying? This is Chicago. You know what I'm saying? This is a big thing. You know, and I'm like, you don't hear this type of response about what's going on in the Department of Children and Family Services. You know what I'm saying? What's going on with these children? You know what I'm saying? Up in these foster care homes. But it was like called into a man. It's a certain way. A certain amount of puppies can be bred. You just can't be out, you know, just breeding these, you know what I'm saying? Having these puppies in this, you know, these type of climate and conditions and they breeding. You know, even with that, people say, you just can't have these dog land, you know, it's a certain climate, you know, it's when it's cold outside, you know? You know, there's a certain, there's politics to race, there's a politics to, you know, typically there's a politics to the gun, you know, there's a politics to, you know, to a pit bull, there's a politics to how black people are dealt with, how we view, you know what I'm saying? We have to acknowledge that. We're live on the record, y'all, here, Fremont Radio, Intellectual Radio. Feel free to call in. Better yet, feel free to call me with us at 929-477-3785. Press 1 to be heard. Any calls and cues to the comrade? Excuse me.
Your mom, for the chairman, no calls and cues. Callers, if you'd like to come into
queue,
please press
1. Fremont. Speaking of puppies, so the comrade down there got our hands full over there. You know what I'm saying? Wild, and you know, over there, reproducing. You know, we hear about this all over the lineage of the Hampton House hounds. You know, what I'm saying, it's reproducing. They over there now. And I guess they took it literally. You know, what I'm saying, they gonna multiply. So, You know, it's the comrade got our hands full around now. Yes, indeed. The Wild Wilds, little Wild Wilds. And you making them stay going to start with that name and them now. You know what I'm saying? It'll be hard to get rid of them in a minute. Start naming them. People come to the house and visit. You say, hold on, man. You visiting or you staying here with what it is? You know? Y'all feel free to come on in with us, y'all. Also, shout out to my man. You know what I'm saying? I got to do a tribute to, again, DMX. You know who? Again, hell of a hit. Hell of a hit. Hell of a hit. You know, they just showing, man, just some tribute videos of this brother, man. Phenomenal. DMX, man. You know, I still, you know, relate to the fact that, you know what I'm saying, he was took out, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you see the powers that be, the system, them, however. Yeah. I mean, if you go back and listen to the stuff he was, you know, suggesting, uncompromised. That's a crime in itself. And this, you know what I'm saying, this from our community, just the backbone, they could be in the music industry or any other industry, to work at McDonald's. Shit. Man, walk up in there with a backbone if you want to. Get found up in some hot grease somewhere around. And this is the reality. This is the reality. The breaking process lasts long when you get in the ear. You have the ears of the masses of people relating to it. You're up front, man. Yes, indeed. And you know, had a hell of a lot of love for the people. And the people had a hell of a lot. Excuse me. Not had. Have a hell of a lot of love for DMX. That's our man. Yes, indeed. We live and direct, y'all. Making history, taking history, and taping history. Y'all feel free. My beauty is unique right on. Ash Brown Days is what it is. Our man. You know what I'm saying? Segretto. That's Combs. When I come back to New York, I know it's been a minute. Been a minute. I was talking to a brother yesterday at Robert Money's birthday party. He said, man, we got to get you up there, man. You know, get back that way, no doubt. My mate Jackson, so many others. We just talking about. Long held political prisoner, Mumia Abu Jamal, just had heart surgery. I believe it was heart surgery day before yesterday. Which they say was handcuffed to the, you know what I'm saying, to the gurney, the whole lick. And they've been real concerned. It's been cold red. Mumia has a birthday coming up April 24th, and we want y'all, maybe y'all, those who can, make your way to Philadelphia, y'all. Make your way to Philadelphia, April 24th. We're going to try to show off. We're going to try to be on deck there. You know what I'm saying? We're going to try to be on deck. So, y'all, if you know what I'm saying, for Mumia Abu-Jamal, long-held political prisoner. Your thoughts on that? You know what I'm saying? The fact that we fight for the day that he has to celebrate no more birthdays in those concentration camps. Your thoughts about this upcoming Oscars? You know what I'm saying? The history, the records they're breaking. You know what I'm saying? The production, the cast, all that, you know. Type of discussions happening, like even how the movie Judas and the Black Messiah has upped the ante, you know, on other movies they come with, you know. You know, so it's a sense of status, like, you can't be in a relationship, be like, woo, the ante been up, you know what I'm saying? You met this sister here, or sister, and all this guy, she still say, deal with this one guy, so the ante been up, you know what I'm saying? You go grab a certain meal, you know what I'm saying? You come back and say, oh, man, no, I don't. Not right now, the ante been up. The movie has upped the ante. It's up the ante. You know, you ain't no just, you know, Billie Holiday just started getting hot. No, hold on. You ain't gone. You missing some missing this stuff in this storyline here. Ain't no just, you know, Dagwood and Blondie going 9 to 5, and ain't no just no good time. Hold on, ain't no just no the Tyler Perry. Or whatever, we live in some bubble, black men and women relationship. No, some missing here. Okay? Yeah, some good. You talk about the red liner from the real estate companies, the police, you know, putting tickets on the cars, something with the black experience, or this black love experience, and tell me about the music they play on the radio station, something. You know what I'm saying? How white people, you know what I'm saying, got these different, you know what I'm saying, they're politicians and all that. We going to talk about this experience. Some got to be included in this movie. Billie Holiday, you said she didn't perform this, and she came late. No, tell me about this. They call them tickets that they had to use to perform, and, you know what I'm saying, what conditions, you know what I'm saying, growing up and all that, you know what I'm saying? This got up out the poppy leaves in Vietnam and just walked his way over here and found his way in the arms, and, you know what I'm saying, black people? No, I imagine them sell that shit somewhere else now. The ante is being upped. Oh, the Black Panther Party, you know, he just faded away. No, bullshit, this one bad person. No, give me a little more. I just can't see this happening. I just can't see this organization just dissolving, just fading away, like, you know what I'm saying? It was a bad weather day, you know what I'm saying? The people's political maturity is, you know what I'm saying, has been upped. You know what I'm saying? Once that discussion happened, the trickle-down impact. You know, something got to be to this a little more deeper than that. It can't be that base. Why? What you mean by that? You're paranoid. No, the fact that a lot of people have never heard about this, the fact that a lot of people never talked about this, it has to be something to it. It's like you're in a relationship. You're like, man, everybody trying to holler at her. Or your sister, everybody trying to holler to do. Something got to be going on here. You know, what's good? You know, it got to be something to this entire community, our people that, you know what I'm saying? Why we get pulled over all the time? Why we ain't shit? Why we, you know what I'm saying, being targeted? Who putting together these different type of drugs to flood our communities with? Why in prison, the war, and just make up rules, no more than two people walk to a crowd? You know what I'm saying? What's to this? And if you're going to talk about it, no, I just can't get white person to come be our spokesperson all the time. I think we can speak for ourselves. I don't know. We may not articulate it. You know, we don't speak in the Queen's English, but you know, I don't ever see us. You calling us to speak and send Lee at your stories. You know, what I'm saying I've been checking y'all out. I see some issues y'all having y'all families and stuff. You know, Prince William. You know, what I'm saying Queen of England. You know, that fairy tale, you know, the horses coming out, you know what I'm saying, looking all nice and all that, the character. That shit sound pretty good, for, you know, for quite some time. But now I'm up for trying to figure out, you know, I'm making a connection. Like, hey, well, you know, the place that your country has been involved in, and, you know what I'm saying, they got some messed up situations, and, you know what I'm saying, stop drawing some correlations. We're going to talk about this here, you know. The more deep, I think that Diana, you know what I'm saying, the car accident there, you know what I'm saying. Let me check. Let's talk about this here. Without this veil of protection for the peas, everything, you know, that you wouldn't even question, you wouldn't even think about, you know what I'm saying. Derek Chauvin, you wouldn't think about this, you know what I'm saying. The peas kill you regardless, or automatically go on attack on the victim. Like, yeah, you know what? You know, before he was on drugs. Before, wait a minute, hold on, man, hold on. You know, are you gonna bring a specialist in? And I got, you know what I'm saying? I ain't no health specialist, but, you know, just shit, just basic common sense and logic. Get your knee on the motherfucking neck. You know what I'm saying? I mean, man, don't take no sides to figure this out, what's going down. You know what I'm saying? And that, you know, and generations of people tell you don't question that. You know, you just go along with it. You know what I'm saying? But no, there are certain stages in the game where the gig is the gig. Now, the gig may not be all the way up, but it's in crisis. It's in crisis. And it upsets the ecosystem. You know, the pigs start looking like, whoa, wait a minute, what's happening? They say Derek Chauvin. They say, talking about even like suicide now. He probably came up with down that hallway, them handcuffs, the pigs handcuffed him. Like, man, all right, you know, you can take him off now. You know, we outside from the cameras, you know what I'm saying? And they like, man, dude, this shit's hot. Shit. And, you know, I was waiting on Derek Chauvin to do one of them, do that line of Wesley Snipes' character did in New Jack City. That's what I was waiting him to do inside the courtroom. Joe said, hold on, this is some bullshit. He's bigger than him. You know, that's what I thought Derek Chauvin was going to do. Jump right up and say, man, hold on, y'all, shit. Derek Chauvin need to do, what's the dude name in L.A.? The man that wrote the manifesto. When the white lady, the other pig, and went in, he kind of got confused. You know, so he be on the animal farm as a motherfucker. You got them uniforms on, you talking, you out there, you know what I'm saying, you kicking motherfuckers' ass, black folks, it kind of get confusing, you know, so you go along, so you start moving, and, you know, so you get confused, so they brought him up on charge or something, so man, I've got his name, he laid it down, he went through a thing, he wrote a manifesto. Christopher Darden. He, man, he wrote a manifesto. He said, man, hold on. Let me show you how this shit been going. This shit, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Man, he said, man, Pig came up with some pig. He said, man, it's a slaughterhouse up in this motherfucker. Man, shit, it's been going down. All the, this had shit. This motherfucker, who created them all? That's why I was William Derrick Chauvin to jump up, walk over there, stand, do Wesley Snipes hold. It's bigger than him. You just break down the training, the shit. Who created him? The shit. I mean, you think there's something? Man, don't be. You say, shit. Man, we've been breaking knees on necks, man, all during the script. Bullets in backs. You say, this the M.O. There's a not peer pressure. Tell me about the pig pressure. How you say you would look funny. You come in like you ain't a pig come up and you ain't up put your knee on a nigga neck. Man, you call yourself a police? Man, lay all that out. Man, Derrick Chauvin, man, all that. Shit, the M.O. You was produced. Shit. Producer, I remember. I think it was Stateville. Free Monster, comrade.
My apologies,
sir.
We have comrade
Roz
on the line.
Well, welcome to
Free Mall
Radio.
Hey, I do that for the
lady. Free Mall, sir.
Free Mall.
Tell
that story. That's
one.
Give a little update. Free Mall.
Free Mall, say it again.
I said, Free Mall, didn't want to interrupt the story.
No, go ahead. I'm picking up, go ahead.
Okay. And real quickly, there was a case that we've been working on, a campaign, a brother named Tyrell Wilson,
who was murdered
right here by Andrew Hall in Danville, Contra Costa County, Northern California, you know what I mean? It's a suburb of the East Bay. And just today, about an hour ago, they just released the body cam footage of his execution. You know what I'm saying? And it's blatant murder, as we suspected. You know what I'm saying? And the word is that the DA is going to press charges on the killer cop, not for this case, but for another murder that he did 3 years prior, Vladimir Alpinella, also in Danville, California. And all of this happened, to your point earlier. This is not happening just because of some teach-ins or some vote-ins and stuff like that. The only reason why the DA is responding and even the Contra Costa County Sheriff's is releasing this stuff is because of the pressure that's being put on them with direct action, you know what I'm saying? We're organizing on the ground, a grassroots level, you know what I mean? So I just wanted to affirm that message that you were saying and, you know, just say justice for Tyrell Wilson, justice for them all. There's a petition going on. You can check it out on my social media pages, as well as definitely if you up for it, check out that footage because it is definitely another case of brutal police terrorism, as Black Panther Party Cubs have properly assessed it. It is terrorism. Yes, sir. So I just want to give that quick update.
Right on, Freeman. That's Tyrell Wilson. Where is it said again?
Tyrell Wilson, and this is in Danville, California. Danville, California.
I've been thinking a lot of these places, though.
His name is Andrew Hall.
I've been thinking a lot of these places. The names be so crazy. It's a prison, Danville, also. In fact, that's what Jerry O'Dinger Dunnigan just was released from.
Right.
And I'll be like, the political significance of these different names and stuff is going to be, man, wow. Yeah, y'all, just check it out, no doubt about it.
Real talk.
Let's see the time. We talk about these cases.
Just want to get that quick update.
Right on. Free them all. Justice for them all, also. Keep all this in context that, you know, again, man, you know, an individual has a case in the community. They hold on, man, this ain't the first time, man. You know what I'm saying? They go back and do some background check. Every case these people been involved in, I mean, recall at minimum. In fact, it was a case here in Chicago, Cook County. I forgot his name. Police, he's locked up now in the Fed joint. Got his name. I can't recall his name. All his cases had to be brought back up. I was mentioning also about Stateville. It was the psychic. And we had we had called you for visits. It was known the type of tactics they would do, you know what I'm saying? Especially with us up in, they call the boondocks. We'd be like, you know what I'm saying, up in, you know, 979 Gallery. This is a place where you wouldn't get your mail for days, and you know, a lot of guards didn't want to work there, you know, because it was real nasty. You know, we never received any, you know, bleacher pass or none of that. You know what I'm saying? It was a different dynamic, and they would bring the ideal prisoners past us. You know. So this is the ideal prisoners. You know how they live, but they said they'll call you for a visit, and other prisoners. We had to pick up, you know, get the bang on the door, flood in the gallery, and we would do it for you because you wouldn't have to do it because you would get, you know, you'd be getting sweaty, so you know, you would get sweaty, you would right on honor, send them a gorilla right on honor, you would get sweaty, you know what I'm saying? So one time they had called for a visit, so especially with me, I knew it'd be extra, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, okay, hopefully we get in 4 or 5 hours so everybody get the banging. So the guard, she came. She said, "You ready for your visit?" I said, "Whoa, wait a minute." I said, what you mean? She said, "Call you for a visit." I said, "Man," I said, "Oh, okay, my fault. You on the new? You just started working here about a week ago." I said, "I got you." "Oh no. I'm, what do you mean by that? You know, I'm a good person." I said, "Okay, I hear you. I don't. So I said, you know, time will tell." Shortly thereafter, show body in the building. Love you right back, man. Real talk. They had a policy that said, if you don't have all your stuff inside this box, you can go out and eat. They gave us these boxes. So they had tried them all. They did them all in the other parts of the prison. So the guards were like, "Man, I'm not even going to work over here in this unit with y'all there. Cause there's going to be some problems, you know what I'm saying?" So it was all over the man. What's going to happen? They bring up to E House, used to be known as B West. Everybody in Stateville know that. That was a legendary place right there, B West. Or later become E House. You know, it was, man, it was going down over there. So they like, "Man, they're going to bring the boxes over there." So, man, they came to, they told me they're going to run us to, we're going to go to lunch. They came through, say, "Anybody don't have this stuff in the box, can't go out." They came through, and the guard, she came through, and she did not let this brother out to go eat. And she, the same guard, I said, "Yep, there you go. You acclimating to the situation." And she put her head down. It's not a question, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if she was a Virgo or a Scorpio or a Taurus, whatever she was. The deal was this pig was starting to become acclimated, you know, since the process. So again, this was not it's the norm, you know what I'm saying? And that's what we, you know what I'm saying? That's, you have to put this again in political context. My phone might die in a minute, get low on the battery, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna keep y'all posted. Y'all took y'all any callers and cues to come, Red?
Grandma, Brother Chairman, no callers and cue callers. If you'd like to come into
cue,
please press 1.
Grandma. Man, we gonna close out in a minute, you know what I'm saying? But it's been so many updates, y'all. Let's keep updating on these upcoming, on the sentencing date of Derek Chauvin. Let's keep our eyes open, our ears open, our heads up, and also our ears open on our condition. In regards to the other three pieces, we gotta come up with cases. And also, all these cases, I know it's a lot to do. People say, "Man, damn, Cham, tired of, you know what I'm saying, hearing about this." Man, I know. I relate where I'm at. People's pain reflects. Yes, we are. That's the whole thing about teamwork. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we got to get that shot of water. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? We have each other's back. Real talk. It's time. It's degrading. It's embarrassing. What is my vision? What is my vision for the Black Panther future? Yeah, we fight for self-determination, the right to determine the destiny of our communities, you know. In the meantime, between time, we gonna relate to the fact that there's a certain amount of freedom in fighting back, you know. This struggle brings, you know what I'm saying, it brings up the beauty as well as the ugliness, you know what I'm saying. And if nothing else, is Brother Arheem, so many other people, they crack on me and say, "Chairman, they clear now." We real big about that. Let's get clear. If nothing else, gonna get some clarity around here. You know what I'm saying? We not on this plantation. I mean, I was locked up in, I forget what camp this was. You go again, one of these old prison stories. Prisons are microcosm outside communities. So when we say these stories, get these war stories, it's really reflective of what goes on in our community at large. You know what I'm saying? So it'll give you an analysis so people say, "Damn, I can relate to that." It was his brother. He was in the joint. We locked up. He had his prison shirt buttoned up real, you know, nice creased up. He would walk with his little briefcase, you know, and he, you know, it was, you know, his head was up, you know, it was not proud, but it was a, you know, it was a class position, you know, more that Great Poupon sort of position, you know. So he looked down the rest of the French mustard eating individuals with arrogance. I said, man, this dude can't be in the same prison that we in. I said, what you mean, chairman? I said, look at him, man, look at him. So I bumped to him one time, you know, he say, yes, brother, I know you go through a lot of situations. You have to look at this different. I said, well, do tell. Explain to me, you know, why you know what I'm saying, where you be at? I said, man, I think they're going to take you for a drug drop. He said, what you mean? I said, oh, dude, you be high? You know what I'm saying? Man, all this stuff going on, you be all in. He said, no, you have to look at this as a college. I said, what? He said, yeah. I said, dig that. I said, man, I never thought about it. I said, you can't change your courses when you want to change your courses, man. I said, you know what I'm saying? The beat downs and the tear gas is shooting at us, you know. So one day I said, man, this dude is getting out at nighttime. They're taking him out somewhere. He, you know what I'm saying? He can't be that gone. I said, I don't care how class arrogant he is. So I took a chain. That's how I followed this dude. I watched us. Let me go to the unit. I see some follow. So I dip over there, follow him to the unit. I get there, I said, man, I said, your toilet busted like my toilet busted. I said, you got 2-3 packs of ramen noodles like in the cell like I got. I said, man, you in a cage too. I said, with his class position, how he viewed it. I said, wow. And you know what I'm saying? And I tell people think that, you know what I'm saying, your class, if a person has money or not, no, you impacted, you know what I'm saying? You could be in the same jungle. You're in the same jungle. You say, man, why, you know, so look at them chimpanzees and look at, why they, you know what I'm saying, them motherfuckers should be over the silverbacks where they get out, you know what I'm saying? It's a different dynamic. And we got to acknowledge that, y'all. Real talk. We get to acknowledge those contradictions, you know what I'm saying? Move accordingly. Real talk. Right on. We honor. Y'all feel free, you know, since stay cubbed in with us, y'all. Another episode of Freedom All Radio here at Intellectual Radio in the spirit of making history, taking history, taping history. Before we close out, y'all, man. Hey, long live the DMX, y'all. Long live the DMX. And again, your thoughts on this upcoming the Oscars and other dynamics about the groundbreaking moves that the Jews and Black Messiah has, you know, has made and the type of conversations, you know what I'm saying, is happening. Respond to that. Feel free. Make sure we check one more check for any callers. Other than that, just got back in from the land. I was out of range. I missed y'all. No communication for a minute, but we did a lot of communicating. Y'all feel free, y'all, to come in with us. That's what it is. Yes, indeed. Real talk. Let's go with this, King Ebola. Definitely, you know, revolutionary suicide. Minister UEP Newton. Let's go with Asada by Asada Shakur. Let's go with Solidarity Brother by George, Field Marshal George Jackson. Let's go with... I was just reading recently. Something else I was just reading. Man. I need to finish. I had the color pieces I put down. Also, the 19-year-old, tell me, check, you know what I'm saying? I mean, even look at some the comments on that 85 South piece. It's on YouTube. The people, their comments and their summation was really something. You know, that was cracking, man. Chairman be talking too fast. I said, all right, if I'm talking too fast, or y'all listening too slow now, what it is. Real talk. Autobiography of Malcolm X. Yeah. They definitely recommend that. Yes. Right on. There you go. Show you right. Wretched Earth, France Fanon, no doubt. Yes, indeed. Is it my beauty? I see a little bit of both. That's what. Well, you know, I be trying to get as much as I, you know, I get it out. Cause I don't know how, man. Sometimes I think I'm riding on fumes. I don't know how long, you know, I'm gonna be around. Try to get it in as much as we can. Right on. Okay. That America prisoner. But no, okay, I'm gonna hip to that. Okay, I'm gonna check it out. Yes, Paul Robeson. Right, good. Yes, definitely. Yeah, right on. Good point. I appreciate this. Right on, sis. Right on. I appreciate it. Make note, y'all, those books that was recommended. No doubt about it. In the spirit of still shopping and still, and men and women shopping and men and women. Y'all check out these recommended books we just put up. Real talk, y'all. That's what it is. Beautiful. Right on. That's what it is. In the meantime, in between time, and after that, keep your heads up, your eyes open, your fists clenched. What's the call? Free them all. When we come back in with y'all. That's a book. Well, that was a video. An untold history about Oliver Stone. Wasn't that a documentary? Or that's an actual book? Okay, I know. I think it was something. America's History or something. They had a piece on that about a few months back. I remember they had on there. Yeah. I'm going to go so far as to say this, too. I recommend people check out, you know, so much as they... we put a lot of Panther Cub political pills in the applesauce on the movie Judas and Black Messiah, real talk. Okay, so you're right. Right on. Before, I'm going to start checking this stuff a lot more than I've been, you know what I'm saying, the Instagram, especially to shut my Facebook down. So we're working on that, on getting that back up. I'll keep y'all posted. But yeah, definitely, I'll check the inbox. I will. I'm going to ASAP. It's an honor. It's an honor. So, Conrad, what you got to take us out? Give us some DMX if we can to pull up to take us out with.
Already,
yeah. Yes, indeed.
Typically four. Yes, indeed.
Yes, indeed. Free them all. Long live the DMX. Check me. Into the DM. Yeah. I really miss you, but it ain't been the same. I drop a tear when I hear your name. Every other holiday. Miss the DM, man, so I don't miss. Why you gotta be so far away? You say, don't worry. Long live. Okay. But it ain't just like when you... Man, long live the greats, man. Long live the DMX, man. Long live... Long live the Panther Cub, Tupac, man. Long live Sam Cooke, man. Long live Billie Holiday, man. Man, the greats that came with it, man. They put a message in that music. Long live the Marvin Gaye. Real talk. Peter Tosh, man, yes indeed, real talk. That's right, it's a marathon. Sometimes we gotta pull over and get that shot of water, you know what I'm saying? Tag team with each other, y'all, real talk. Yes indeed. Yes indeed, man, the Curtis Mayfields, man, real talk. Yeah, right on, appreciate it. Yeah, we had a power outage where I was at. I was at the loop for a minute. The communication. We're going to send them a gorilla. We're going to push the issue. Real talk. And also, in addition to the people in the Oscars and everybody, those in the ghettos and prisons, they talking about it, man. Phenomenal piece. Yeah, the people are loving it. Real talk. So you're right. Right on. There's no doubt, sir. And Jarvis, back out of jail, doing fine. No fight. Man, DMX, man, the rest of it, man. Ghetto Griots. Yes, indeed. He was a person that went through a lot, you know. This dude, he said he did his first beer when he was 7, you know. Foster cares and institutions he had went through. A lot of struggles, but however, he's still related to the people. You know, Mother Conrad, she fought hard for DMX to be on the soundtrack of the movie Judas and the Black Messiah. Yeah, she did. Yeah, man. It's a movie that you can go back more and more. You look at the movie Judas and Black Messiah. It's more stuff. Even myself, I go back and say, oh, yeah, this piece right here, this part of it, yeah. Soul. Long Sam Cooke. Collins and Brothers. So you ready, right on. I'm gonna come back with y'all. I'm gonna come back in with y'all. Y'all keep y'all heads out of this place. Call them all. Lonely at DMX.